Welcome to episode one. This one's called The Helmet. Welcome to the first episode, The Helmet. Right, it was the summer of 76, and it was a hot summer. The hottest summer the UK ever had. So what happened was, it was the dawn of punk, someone tried to kill Bob Marley, and Brian, well, Brian did what Brian did every single summer. I was carted off to Ireland, because that's what Irish parents do to their children. They send them off to Ireland for their summer holidays. I personally think it was a summer holiday for them, not for us. Regardless to say, I went to stay with my auntie that year, and she was in a place called Kildare. She's got a son called Paul. He was 20. This day, he comes into the yard, and he's got an RD350 Yamaha. My eyes nearly popped out of my head. He says, "Do you want to have a go on the back?" Well, of course I do. That was it. Came back to the house, and I'm in. I put pieces of cardboard on my push bikes to make it sound like a motorbike. I'd pretend I was racing around on a motorbike when I was racing around on my push bike back in London. It was in my head, I was gonna get one, and that was it. Hey, lucky enough for me, it was 1977, and guess what happens? Yes, I'm going back to Ireland again. I'm going back to my cousin Paul's, and this year, that was a great year, 77. Barry Sheen was world champion again. We were following him really close. Motorcycle Weekly was our go-to paper every single week, and look at the racing pages. It was on TV. It was superb. Heroes. Wasn't as hot that year. Star Wars came out. The Queen's Silver Jubilee was 1977 as well. Anyway, I digress. Let's go back to Paul's house. And there I see his RD350. He has totally done it up. It's got drop handlebars. It's got a racing seat. It's got expansion chambers. He starts it up like a two-stroke. Bing, 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 pop, 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 pop. Revs it. It's like a fly. I go on the back again. It's just too much for my poor head. It was a brutal year, 1982. Started off with the coldest winter since the war. Then we had the highest unemployment figures since the war. And then, do you know what? To cap it all off, we went to war with Argentina over the Falkland Islands. Time magazine, they've always had questionable judgment, in my opinion, but the man of the year was the computer. Funny that, because the first CD was sold in Japan. It was a really cool year for music as well, 1982. Guess what? Thriller was released. 25 million copies sold. Brilliant album. Can you believe it's that old? Anyway, Eye of the Tiger, another great song came out. Don't You Want Me Baby by the Human League. Abracadabra, Steve Miller. Jay Giles did his famous song, Centerfold. 1982 was a great year for movies. We had Blade Runner, A Vision of the Future, Beginning of Cyberpunk. We had the two Alien movies. We had E.T., the friendly alien. We had The Thing, the not so friendly alien. Now that was a cracker of a movie. We had Tron with their computerized motorcycles. Brilliant graphics in that film. First Blood came out, the first Rambo film. I think we're up to 72 now, aren't we? Or are we not? I don't know. And then we had Arnie. Arnie came out, he was Conan. So that's just a quick little insight into music and entertainment for me that was going on that year. Obviously there was a lot more going on in 1982, but for me, you know, those are things that interest me. And after all, it's about me, isn't it? Now I turned 16 years old. Now by law, I'm allowed to ride a moped. All right, 50cc moped, which is great. So, the unstoppable force being me met the immovable object being my mother. And it was never going to happen. whilst you're living under my roof, you are not having a motorcycle. Now, I'm sure loads of you out there have met this immovable object, but sometimes the immovable object has got to move, and the unstoppable force kind of slows down a bit. But this is where it gets interesting. If I couldn't have a bike, I was going to buy a helmet. The helmet. Now, interesting one, this one, because I'll tell you why. I had to go past the Kawasaki shop. Now, this was nirvana for a young kid like me. I'd go past the Kawasaki shop and I'd go in and I'd look at all the big bikes. Oh, there was Z1s, all the two-stroke 750s and 500s. It was just fantastic. I'm sure they got absolutely sick of me. Oh, here comes that punk-ass little kid looking at all the bikes doing nothing. But one day I went in there and on the wall they had a bright green full-faced Bell helmet special offer, £25. Whoa, £25. I thought I want it. I really did. I thought I want it, and I did want it, and I'm gonna buy it. But I had a job. I had a little Saturday job which earned me £10 a day working in a sweet shop, right? And so I had to save a couple of weeks at least to get the money to buy the helmet. I could buy anything I want, really, you know, within reason. So I went out and I bought the helmet. You can imagine what happened when I took it home. First of all, there was a bit of banter and laughing and joking and taking a piss, but it was in my room. I polished it, I cleaned it, I took it on, I took it off, dreaming about motorbikes, dreaming about my first motorbike and how I'm going to be wearing this helmet. This is where it happens. This is where the dream actually starts. And I buy my first C50 moped. And that's for the next episode. So thanks for watching. Let's get into it.
First of all, here's the disclaimer. I do not look anything like Hulk Hogan. And my mum, she doesn't look anything like Andre the Giant. Here's a few pictures of my mum, just to show you that. Now, my mum passed away in 2015, and yeah, there's not a day goes by when I don't miss her. She was a great friend, a great mother, and just a great human being. She looked after me, all my mates, and my sister. Yeah, and everyone just called her Ma, really. So this one's for you, Mum. Love you, baby.
I hope you enjoyed that episode. If you did, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. And I'll tell you what, I'll see you next week.